Praise the Lord. You have just joined the midweek service of Believers Family Worship Center, and we are located at 1604 East Admiral Doyle Drive in New Iberia. So excited about God, so excited about what He is doing. We are located not only in New Iberia, but on the World Wide Web. You can reach us at believersfamily.org, as well as Facebook Live and YouTube Live. We're going to go to the Father now in prayer. As we get together tonight, we're so excited about the Word of God. So why don't you join me as we pray? Father, we come before you now in the name of Jesus, and we are so blessed by who you are. We are so blessed by what you are doing in our lives. As we look forward to the great things that you have already prepared for us, we thank you for freedom of utterance tonight. May your word go forth, and as it goes forth, may you confirm it with many signs, wonders, and miracles. So excited about you. So excited about the manifestation of who you are. So it is in the matchless, wonderful name of Jesus that we say amen and amen. Well, I tell you, this is my favorite time of the year, and I don't know about you, but I pray it is yours too. We are looking forward to our celebration, the greatest celebration, the celebration of the resurrection of our Lord. And tonight, we're going to go into the Word. We're going to Ephesians chapter 6. And in Ephesians chapter 6, it says in verse 10, it says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might." Be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. All of creation is now waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. And as we get into walking into the victory that our Lord has so graciously provided, He says here, "Finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord." That strength comes from the supernatural power of God. He says in other parts of the scripture that the same scripture, that is what He says in Romans, the same scripture that raised Jesus from the dead also dwells in us. He quickens us. So by the quickening of the Holy Ghost, as we get into that quickening, He says for us to be strong in the Lord. It is so exciting to know that our Lord has so many tremendous things prepared for us. There is a supernatural power that is now made available to us. So when we are strong in the Lord, first of all, He says to be. So excited about that. He says, be strong. You know, little words, when we get into Bible study, God doesn't just speak words. He doesn't just give us words just to make sentences. But that word be is so phenomenal because it says exist, be in the Lord, exist in the Lord. And not only for us to exist, but it says for us to be present in the Lord, be in the Lord, be strong in the Lord. Be present. As Christians, as we grow, the Lord wants us to continually grow in the Lord. He wants us to continually grow in what has already been done. Continually increase in what has already been done. Be strong in the Lord. It is already done. Jesus has already resurrected. He has already manifested. So He says, be strong in the Lord. That supernatural power that causes us to fight the unseen demonic forces in the world. That supernatural power, it says to us, watch this, be infused with the strength of God. Be infused. That means that there is an inward strength that we are to be able to receive from the Lord, and He wants us to ever increase in that strength. Be strong inwardly in the power of the Lord And as we are infused, with, watch this, an excessive dose of inward power. You know, we are facing so many things on so many levels, but there is a power that the Lord gives us, an inner strength that he gives us. He says, be strong in the Lord and be strong, not only in the Lord, but be strong in the power of his might. It is so awesome to see that no matter what the attack is, no matter what comes against us, we are to not only be strong in the Lord, but we are to successfully oppose any kind of force that comes against us. You know, when you think about the book of Genesis, beloved, when God said, let there be, he says, allow it to be. And when God speaks, things come into existence. Well, when he's telling us to be strong, he is saying that there is a power, there is an inner strength that God gives us, that he allows us to partake of, and not only the strength of his dynamite, his dunamis, but that word there is kratos. It says it's a strength and a power that is going to be demonstrated. You know, when Jesus died on the cross, when he went into the grave, there was a power that went into hell that was demonstrated right in the domains of Satan's territory. Because why? There was a power that could not hold him down. There was a power that could not keep him there. There was a power that in the strength of Satan's domain could not keep him down. So now he's saying for us to be strong in the Lord and in the power. There is a power that is given to us that even though we have to walk through things, even though we have to confront things, even though we walk through situations and circumstances, he says that there is a power. And listen, that power is, I love that, might. It is a kratos. It is, my God, it is a, it's like a muscle. You know, when muscles are built, when people go, you know, to the different spas and to the different exercise places, they gain strength in their muscles, but that is because weight is put on them. When we are walking in the power of God and in the strength and the power of his might, we walk through situations and circumstances that may seem weighty, that may seem a little heavy, but even in that time, he's building spiritual strength inside of us. And as that strength is given to us, we literally be able to display the power of God in our lives. So, you know, we don't want to think it's strange, beloved, when we walk through trials and when we walk through certain things, we gain strength at every hand. So he says, be strong in the Lord. The purpose is to infuse us with his power, to infuse our life with his strength. I like that. An excessive dose, that Greek word means an excessive dose of inward strength. So we're able to withstand every attack and we're able to successfully oppose any kind of force. I'm going to read this scripture now in the Amplified. It says, in conclusion, be strong in the Lord. Draw your strength from him and be empowered through your union with him and in the power of his, watch this, boundless might. As sons of God, we are to grow and we will see the power of God exhibited in our life, not from the absence of adversity, but even in the middle, in the midst of adversity, we're to the place where we are able to be strong in him. We are able to be overcomers. We are able to overcome situations, overcome circumstances. One of my favorite verses, you know, and my favorite, you know, I always say, is the one that I'm working with at the time. I love it the way it says it in Ephesians chapter 1. It says this. It says in verse 17 that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, that he may give unto us the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, that the eyes of our understanding may be enlightened, that we may know what is the hope of his calling, what is the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. But look at this. What is the exceeding greatness, that we may know not only head knowledge, not only the ability to communicate or the ability to study, but that we might experience, look at this, the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe. There is an exceeding great power that God intends for us to manifest. He says that we may know what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, and it is according to the working, according to the working of his mighty power, which God wrought in Christ. You know what? It is just beyond understanding. That is why he says here that God would grant unto us the understanding, because the same kind of power that raised up Christ from the dead on our behalf, he says here that it is that kind of power, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. Beloved, it is sometimes hard to even fathom that no matter what kind of demonic forces come our way, no matter what sickness, no matter what dis-ease, no matter what the enemy does in the economy and the political realms, no matter what comes against our families, no matter what the enemy throws our way, he says if we are to understand that the same power, the same quickening force that raised Jesus from the dead is available to us. So when he says, be strong in the Lord, that means our character, that means our lifestyle, be strong in the Lord. It means for us to walk mightily in the word of God. It says that that means that there is power available to us. So be strong in the Lord. Understand that there is an exceeding great power that is available that works on our behalf. So be strong in the Lord and in the power, listen, not of our might, but in the power of his might. There are some things that are beyond our brain. There are some things that it is beyond our own human wisdom. There are some things that happen is beyond our capacity to even overcome in our own strength. He says, but you must be able to walk in the power of God. I must be able to walk in the power of God. It is to experience what happened when Jesus was raised from the dead. He's got us seated together with him, so now we can access through the authority of his name. We can not only call on his name, but we can access through the authority in his name that same quickening power of the Holy Ghost. He said the same power that raised up Jesus from the dead shall also quicken and give life to our mortal bodies. It is so amazing that God allows us to not only be privy to, but to have access to the same, listen, it is the same Holy Ghost that raised Jesus from the dead. The same Holy Ghost. We celebrate resurrection. You know, as sons of God, you know, all of creation is waiting on us as sons of God. And it is so that we have more than head knowledge. It is that we have more than mental assent. It is, you know, more than just to agree with what the word says. But the Lord wants us to experience him in such an awesome way that as we live our life, hallelujah, we're able to let it exude. You notice he says, be strong in the Lord. There is a power on the inside of us that must be activated, that must be quickened. And how is that power activated? And how is that power quickened? We must have our minds renewed It is not only a heart-mouth connection, but our minds must be renewed to understand that we're on another level, to understand that we're in a new kingdom, to be able to receive it and to believe it. Listen, depression may come, difficulties may come, but we must understand that. I love it in 1 John. He says, you have overcome, my little ones. You have overcome. So we must exercise, we must be able to use that power that is available to us, that we may be able to display that power of God. I love it because it says in Romans chapter 8, verse 2, we're under a new law, the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus. We are under new principles. We're under a new authority. We're under new mandates. And it is the law of the Spirit of life, which is in Christ Jesus. But how are we going to walk in that? How are we going to be able to exemplify? It is the power of God. When we are led by His Spirit, we are sons of God, and now the power of God is made available to us. It is so interesting that Paul said that I may know Him in the power of His resurrection. There is a dunamis power. Hallelujah. There is an authoritative power that God gives us. There is an energy, hallelujah, that God gives us. There is a force, hallelujah, all wrapped up in the Holy Ghost, all wrapped up so that we are able to be overcomers. As Christians and as sons of God, we get so caught up with our natural ability. We get so caught up in our natural experiences that when things happen, sometimes we forget that we are not just mere men. We forget that there is a power, the creative force of the Holy Ghost that is on the inside of us, but it must be applied to our life. We must be able to experience it. You know, I love Easter time. I love when we celebrate the resurrection because it causes me, I don't know about you, but it causes me to come to the conclusion that there is more to what's on the inside of me, because the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, the same power that raised Him from the dead dwells in me. And now it becomes reality that greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world. We must be able to have our minds renewed to the Word of God so that the power of God that is available to us can be accessed, so that we're able to be led by His Spirit, and that we get to the place, I love it, where there are no impossibilities in God. Why do we say our mind must be renewed? Why do we look at, he says, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. How do we get to the place? Listen, we have to get to the place where it is just as salvation is, when we believe in our heart. And now when we confess with our mouth, there is a new force that is being activated, and it is now released. So regardless as to what our need is, regardless as to what our desire is, there is a purpose, there is an intention. Be strong in the Lord. There is a purpose that He the purpose of the power that He infuses us with is so that no matter what we walk through, we have an excessive dose of, watch this, inner strength. An excessive dose, not just a little bit, but you know, God always does exceedingly abundantly above all that. Listen, there is a power. So listen, not only to do, but it takes power sometimes to just rest. It takes power to be able to hold on and wait on God. It takes power. What is that? An ability of faith that we are able to move out in the things of God. Beloved, we're living in such an exciting time. We are living in such a time where the power of God is available. When we go through the Gospels, His power is present to heal. When we look at how He provided, His power is so still ready for us. But we need instruction for us to be able to have needs met, to have desires. But when we give God the glory, when we our desire is to please Him in all of our ways, there is a power that is available to us. And not just any, we're talking about the power of God. We are talking about releasing His ability in our life. We are talking about taking advantage of the authority that He has given us. So we must remind ourselves, we must train ourselves to walk in the Word of God. You might say, well, prophetess, you're talking about the power of God. You're talking about, I'm going to tell you how simple it is for all of us to access the power of God. Paul said it like this: I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. You know why? It is, what is the power? The gospel of God is the power of God unto salvation, to the Jew first and to also the Greek. The gospel, when we walk in the gospel, when we live in the gospel, when we believe the gospel, when we apply the gospel, there is a power of God that is now available to us, and we must appropriate the power of God in every situation of our life. To bring it down to the simplest terms, we're not in this world alone. We're not in this world by ourselves. In fact, it is impossible to live a productive Christian life without the power of God. Why? Because it cannot be done in our own strength. It cannot be assumed. It cannot. Listen, the power of God is available. He has made it so available. We must have our minds renewed. Our heart must believe that we receive. He says, to them that have received Him, He gives us, watch this, power, authority to become sons of God, to be able to walk and access what He has already delivered through the crucifixion and the resurrection of our Lord. We're in a season where people are making vows. We're in a season where folks are fasting, where people are praying, and all of those things are good, but it will not profit us any if we are not walking in relationship with Him, walking in an ability to be able to demonstrate, walk it out, what's inside of us, being released on the outside of us, where the creative power of God can be made manifest, so that even those that don't believe, they're able to see the power, experience the power. There is someone somewhere in the earth that is waiting, someone in our own vicinity that is waiting for the power of God to manifest. There is some family that is close to you, that is close to me, that is waiting on the manifested power of God that comes through us. It is so exciting to know that even in these days, God is so manifested in our life that men and women will want to come to Him. Why? Because He says it is the goodness of God that leadeth men to repentance. Our life is on display. There is power that God has made available to us, but we must believe that we receive and that we walk in it. There is a move of God, a move that comes right out of us. He says, and out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. He didn't just say one river. He said rivers of living water. That living water is the life of God that manifests. It flows out of us. There are folks all around us that have no hope. There are people all around us that are literally just existing. They get to know who our God is by the manifestation of His life and His power in our lives. So, beloved, no matter what you may be walking through, no matter what situations, circumstances that may come our way, no matter how things may seem like it's going to turn out, just remember there is a power of God that is available, an authority. There is a dunamis. That's where we get the word dynamite from. There is an energy. Hallelujah. There is a force that is greater than even human life. It is God's own life, his power that is available to us that causes us to overcome. I love it the way Romans says it. And what shall separate us from his love when he goes through all of that? I'm so excited. It says, no, in all of these things, I'm closing with Romans chapter 8, verse 37. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded, are you persuaded? For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us. Listen, separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Why can it not separate us? Because we have been infused. We are partakers. We have been infused. So no matter what happens on the outside, we are in union with him. We are in communion with him. We are able to receive from his life. And there is nothing in this natural realm that will be able to separate us from his love. And his love, because he is our Father, he releases all that he has in order that we are more than conquerors. Well, tonight we've been talking about the power of God. And certainly we need it. And certainly we cannot live without it. It is to keep our minds stayed on him and to execute, decree and declare, execute what God would have done in our life. In other words, let it be not only continual growth, but continually growing in what has already been done. Continually growing in whatever has been, whatever God has already promised. We are increasingly growing in the manifestation of the power of God. We love you today, and we are so excited to be able to bring you, listen, this is good news to know that you are not in this planet by yourself. All you have to do is give your life to him so that you can now come in union with him. You can be able to be a son of God, a daughter of God, a child of God, and you're able to partake of his divine nature and be able to release the power that is available to you. You're not saved today. Why don't you come on and let's pray. Let's give our heart to the Lord. Just say, God. Bow your heads just in honor of him and just say, God, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. I confess with my mouth and I believe in my heart that God, you raised Jesus from the dead. And because you have, I believe that I receive salvation right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you for washing me in the blood of the Lamb. Thank you for writing my name in the Lamb's book of life. I give your name praise and I give your name glory. I receive in Jesus' name. I say amen and amen. Beloved, listen. We're in the last days. We cannot live this life by ourselves. Get in the word. Believe the word. Walk through the word. There is a power available to us that is greater than man, any man can ever create, because it is the very power of the life of God. Right now, we are preparing to bring our tithes, to bring our offerings. This is our midweek service. So right now, right where you are, if you are preparing to give tonight, you can mail your tithes, your offerings, your seed sowing. You might say, well, prophetess, why are we talking about? Listen, God called us blessed. He said, be blessed, be fruitful, multiply. He said, replenish, subdue, take dominion. There's a word in that cycle of blessing called replenish. It says, freely you have received, so freely you give. That is a part of replenishing. So a lot of times we're wondering why we're not subduing. You know, why are we not taking dominion? If we're blessed and if we're multiplied, what about replenishing? We have to sow back into. He says, bring the tithes so that my house can be replenished. He says, bring your tithes, bring your offerings so that there could be meat in my house. It could be replenished. He says, and as you do that, see if I won't open up the windows of heaven for you. So he says, for us to be blessed, multiply, hallelujah. Be fruitful, multiply, replenish. So bring your tithes. How do you do that? You can mail it to P.O. Box 10306, New Iberia, Louisiana, 70562. Or you can text to BFWCGIVE. Text BFWCGIVE to the number 28748. Or you can Cash App. To $BFWC1604, Cash App, $BFWC1604, or you can go online to believersfamily.org, believersfamily.org, and when you do that, follow the promptings, and you can bring your tithes, bring your offerings, bring your seed sown. Listen, the Lord says to us in Leviticus, the tithes, the offerings, they're holy unto God. You have received word tonight that is holy. This word God sends out, he watches over that word to perform that word in your life. And as we receive that word, now we give, hallelujah, out of obedience to the word. And there is something miraculous that goes on in the realm of the spirit. God is watching over that word to perform the word of the Lord in your life. So as you are prepared to bring your tithes, your offerings, your seeds sown, we will together make our declaration. We say, Father, we thank you for the seed. You give seed to sowers, we thank you for the seed. You give bread to eaters, we thank you for the bread. You multiply our seed sown, we thank you for multiplication. We're the head and not the tail. We live above only and not beneath. We're the lenders and not the borrowers. Everything we put our hands to shall prosper. So what we do, we have power. What do? We go ahead and say, receive a hundredfold. Go ahead and receive a hundredfold. We're out of debt. All our needs are met. We've got plenty more to seed and store. We bind lack, poverty, and insufficiency, and we loose the supernatural abundance of God in our life now. The supernatural abundance of God in our life now. One more time. The supernatural abundance of God in our life now. Well, beloved, so blessed to be able to be a part of your life, to be able to bring you the word declaring and decreeing the power of God, especially for you. I don't know about you, but I'm counting down 45 days, 3 hours, 24 minutes, 41 seconds to Easter. Why is that? We want the power starting tonight to continue to grow. We want it to increase. We want it to flow. Hallelujah. So as we come together on one accord, we're able to receive the miraculous. We're able to receive, hallelujah, what men can't do. Well, I'm telling you, we're just looking forward to an explosive time in God, demonstrating with signs, wonders, and miracles. You need to be a part of our fellowship. We want to invite you to be a part of us as we're on this journey displaying the glory of God. We are Believers Family Worship Center. We're located at 1604 East Admiral Doyle Drive in New Iberia, Louisiana. We're sending a very special shout out to our very own Pastor Tammy. She is in recovery, doing well, but we're sending a big God bless you, Pastor Tammy. Listen, we are waiting to see you jumping and leaping and running and dancing for joy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're sending a God bless you to Pastor Tam and Pastor Greg. And to all of you that we're standing in faith. We believe God with you for miracles, signs, and wonders. Be it unto you according to his word. So as we leave tonight, let us go to the Father in prayer. It's been a joy just talking to you and releasing into your life the power of God. Let us pray. Father, we thank you that tonight, for those that need your power so graciously, we thank you, Father, that that power, your power that is on the inside of us, is being activated even right now, so that your word would manifest as it grows increasingly inside of us. Allow your word to manifest. We give your name praise. We give your name glory for every miracle, every sign, and every wonder. Be it unto us, Father, according to your word. Now, Lord, may you continue to bless us and keep us. Cause your face to shine upon us. Be gracious to us. Lift up your countenance upon us and give us your peace. May your righteousness go before us. May your glory be our rear guard. And it is in the name of Jesus that we say amen and amen.